Let's understand why, what are the application of queues. So module top again and module. Now in this one, let me save this as queue.sv. Queue, it is simple. Everything I can still retain from my dynamic array, and let us see how we can do that. So here, this is what I was doing, isn't it? Adding elements to it and print it and deallocate it. I'm going to just copy it, paste it here. Now if I have to change this guy to queue, all I need to do is use a dollar here. That's it. This makes it a queue. Now if you give the size here, makes it a packed array. Oh, sorry, if you give a size here, makes it a fixed size array. If you don't give size, then you need to give it at random. It's a trade-off, right? It is a compromise that you have to make. You give a size at compile time, fine. If you don't give one, someplace you have to give it, right? That someplace is runtime. So that is the advantage of using dynamic array. What is the advantage? That you get to choose the size. You get to choose your size at the runtime. Fine. That is done. Now, if you don't know the size, what you will do? To change the value at runtime, you need to know the size. But if you do not know the size, what will you do? That is, you end up using a queue. Size of the queue, same way. Now, are we allocating a memory here? No. We are not allocating the memory. We are not allocating the memory. To allocate the memory, you have to use it. Add data to queues to allocate memory. To allocate memory. Now, if you do not have the memory, one thing you have to progressively understand the differences here is that, see, if you have memory, you have indexes. You don't have memory, you don't get indexes. As simple as that, isn't it? You have memory, you have indexes. You don't have memory, you don't get indexes. Now what will I do? You cannot say, now this size returns 0, isn't it? I want to push 10 location data into it. Okay, fine. All I need to do is data dot push back. Data dot push underscore back. Now, we will, after every pushback, we will display the size of the data. After every pushback, we will display the size of the data. Here, what am I doing? I am not giving the size here. I am saying, I don't know the size. Dollar means I don't know the size. If you don't know the size, it makes it queue. Now, first display the size is 0. Then come back here. Now I cannot use dot size because dot size is 0. I equal to 0, I less than 0, this for loop will never enter. Isn't it? Then what am I doing? Data dot pushback. See, one simple. No memory, no size, no indexes. If you do not have indexes, what will you loop through? Now, what is queue? In queue, the memory is automatically expanded and shrink. How is the memory expanded? Memory is expanded when you use it. How to use it? There are two doors of access to the queue. By default, the depth of the queue is infinite, and there are only two doors via which you can access them. One is front, the other one is back. So you need to say either go from the front or go from the back. Now here, what am I saying? Push back data, isn't it? So then I'm displaying you the size. Every time I push one data, the size gets increased by one. Then, can I display all of the data with this one? Yes, I can do that. Yes, I can do that. To print the data, I can still use it. But there is one problem with this one, or problem might come. We will see that. Okay, we will discuss the problem as well. First, how to use the location. Yes, to use the location, either use push back or push front. Both one and the same. It's just that through which door you are entering and in what fashion are you using. We will cover that as well. So first, Verilog, and I will say queue. Or did I not end? Yeah, I did not end. By using insert, we can add at any place we want. Yes, that is your jumping topics. That needs to be learned tomorrow. First, for now, you should not. That is the whole. See, again, Q needs to support verification as well. In verification, you want to alter things. In verification, you want to alter things, isn't it? So that is when you use insert and all. Forget it for now. For now, first thing, you don't have, this is the best way to remember. You have memory, you don't have memory. First, you have memory. In what we have memory? Fixed arrays. Yes, you have memory, you have indexes. Fine. Then in dynamic arrays, you don't have memory. If you don't have memory, allocate the memory and use indexes. In queues, you don't know any size. Then how will you allocate a memory? That means you don't have memory, you don't have get indexes. How you will do? You'll put that memory management. Think of it this way. Fixed arrays, your fixed memory, your indexes, your management. Dynamic arrays, yes, no memory, but you know how much of a memory you want. So you will allocate the memory, you will use the memory. So all that for loops that you put are nothing but memory management, right? How you want to push the data in it, how you want to extract data from it. Then I got to resize the memory, fine, but I don't know the size. I don't know the size. See, once you don't know the size at compile time, use dynamic arrays. When you know the size, fine, that is completely fine. But when you don't know the size and you don't want to do memory management, you don't know the size, you don't want to do the memory management, you put it all onto the simulator, then what do you get? You come across queues. What is queues? The memory management is up to the simulator. The indexes are managed by the simulator. The allocation and deallocation of memory is managed by the simulator. What are you worried about? You have been only given two things. What is this? Increasing the level of abstraction, don't you think? Now, in case of dynamic arrays or fixed size arrays, you have to loop through 0 to the last. Are you doing that here? See? All you are doing is using one API called as pushback, data.pushback. Now what it is doing, see, every time you push back 11111 size, don't you think internally it is using this construct that I taught you automatically to expand the memory? This one, ganga. This one, every time it is happening previous size plus one, previous size plus one. So what is happening? The memory management is up to the simulator now. It is adding, see, every time you use pushback, one increment up till 10. Why? You are pushing 10 data. The size has become 10 now. Now, after that, can you loop through it? Yes. Once you have memory, you get to use the indexes. See, I'm looping through memory and I have all my indexes. I'm looping through memory, all of my indexes. Then what about removing data from it? Now, the memory management, right? Memory management says when you say pushback, that means you are creating one more new memory and putting data to it. This is looping through all of it and seeing what data is present there. But we need to, I said, when to use queues? When to use queues? Queues needs to be used. First thing, it should be used when a point in this one. Insertion and extraction order is important. Size or amount of data is not known, as in monitors, right? As in monitors. There are drawbacks of these as well. We'll probably discuss them tomorrow. Okay, first the advantages. Now, we allocated the memory. We print the data from the memory. How to deallocate the memory? Dot delete. Yes, that will completely deallocate the memory. But there is something called as pop back as well. So, as I said, insertion and extraction order is important. But if I'm inserting data just like this and I'm looping through all of it, how do I make sure that what is my insertion order and what is my extraction order? To understand what is your insertion order and extraction order, you need to use it in pairs. How do you use it in pairs? You said push back here. You need to say pop front over here. when you get the order, you come back here, you see that you'll get the order when you're coming from here. Let's say you're pushing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you pop from front like this, now you will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? Insertion and extraction order is important. Push back, pop front. If you're using push front and pop back. Right? Insertion and extraction order will become when you use it in correct pairs. Push back, pop front. Push front, pop back. Isn't it? Pop underscore back. This is how you should use it. Now all I need to do is cut this from here. Paste it here. Data. Now I will also display you size. Comma data dot size. Now with this you will see whenever you have popped the data from it. Whenever you have, you can use pop back as well. Now you will see that whenever you have popped the data from it, its size automatically reduces. The allocating, so two things are put to the comp in going from fixed size arrays to dynamic arrays. You took memory management on your own. You said, I am going to be the one who decides what, how much memory I want, when I want to expand it, when I want to shrink it. It's just that the memory is not fixed anymore. It is resizable. That is the only advantage you got in case of a dynamic array. But in going from dynamic arrays to queues, what is the additional advantage you got? What is the additional advantage you get? Is that you offloaded the entire memory management to the simulator. Now you say, I don't want to play around with the size. And first of all, I don't know the size. What I will do, I will put entire memory management on you. I want you to automatically allocate the memory when I'm using more locations. I want you to automatically deallocate the memory when I am popping the data from it. All I need is my order importance. The order in which I push is the order in which I get. Now, this is FIFO, right? First in, first out. Don't you think Q is FIFO? Don't you think Q is FIFO? But I say it is LIFO also. But I will say LIFO also. How? Because see, you have four APIs. Push back, pop front. You have push back, opposite is pop front. Then you also have push front, pop back. Now, it is the order in which you use it makes it FIFO. You push it from the back, pop it from the front. Or you push it from the front, pop it from the back, makes it a FIFO. But if you push it from front and use pop front, it will become a LIFO. That we will see tomorrow, or you take that as an assignment. Now in the same example, I'm using push back and pop front. Then it is making it a queue. See here, all the 10 locations you have pushed, random data are here. Then I'm popping data out. Oh, I have to use percentile H here. Sorry about that. Or else you'll not be able to match the data. Come back here. See, I'm popping the data, and as and when I'm popping the data, see the size is reducing. After the pop of last data, the size became zero. So this is queues. And how do you index through it? More interesting things on how to use it as a LIFO, how to use the bounded queue, how to understand what is the index for front and what is the index for the back, that is front door, back door, all the details of it we will see tomorrow. But one first question before we leaving: do you want to randomize the queue? See, we saw what is fixed size array, then we learned what a dynamic array is. We also learned in a dynamic array is how to randomize it. All fine, but here tell me, do you want to also randomize the queue? The answer is yes or no. If yes, how? What constraints you will write? Tell me. Simple answer, no, you don't want to, because that is not the application scenario. That is not the application.